What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to a special First and 49ers pregame podcast. And right behind me right now is Levi Stadium. So what's going on, guys? It's your host, Cole McMahon, and I just had the biggest surprise today. Today I was coming home from college, and my mom was just telling me that we're going straight home the next day, Saturday, only to find out that my dad was in the car, and the big surprise was they're taking me to a 49ers game. So this is going to be my first game back at Levi Stadium since the NFC Championship game, and I'm in a hotel right now, right behind Levi Stadium. I mean, just the view you can't really see right now, but I put this video right here. It just the stadium's right there, and it's just nuts. Biggest surprise of the year so far. Biggest present for me. I'm just so thankful for my parents for doing this. Get to see the Niners play against the Falcons. And let me just say, this is the biggest game of the year for the Niners. Playing against the Falcons team, 6-7. Not the greatest team at all, but they still can find ways to win if the 49ers beat themselves up and if we don't get our job done. Like I said. This is the biggest game because if the Niners win this game, their chances boost up to 75 to 85% chance of making the wild card. And if we lose, I think our chances drop down to like 30%. So, I mean, every single game in the rest of the year is going to end up being big for us. And like I said, I think we have a shot of winning out this year. The Niners struggled at home this year, but fortunately we won the past two home games, the Rams game and the game right before this, the Vikings game at home. So, I mean, it's going to be a fun game. Some big names in this game is obviously the Debo Cordell Patterson comparison versus each other. Because both players are pretty similar. Both teams use them as a running back, wide receiver duo. The Falcons have specifically been using Patterson as a running back this year. He has five rushing touchdowns. I think he has over 500 yards rushing and receiving. But Debo's got the over 1,000 yards receiving this year. And he has six rushing touchdowns. So, I mean, the touchdowns are obviously pretty similar. But I think Debo obviously is, I think, just way more talented than Cordell or Patterson. Obviously, more versatile just because he's also younger and everything. Patterson's like 30 years old. But I think as long as the 49ers are able to play consistent defense, I think it'll be a lot easier to find Patterson where he's going on his routes and everything and being easier for the Niners D to stop him because they don't use him just like Debo Samuel, how he is in our offense, where we move him around everywhere, left and right. That's just the versatility that Debo has that Patterson doesn't, which I believe gives the 49ers this edge on the defensive side to stop the Falcons. Let's get into the keys of the game. Number one, it's definitely going to be get the run game going early. We obviously have Elijah Mitchell out right now. It's a knee injury, and it's not even looking like he's going to be back for Thursday Night Football, which the Niners play this week against the Titans. So that's good. That's a big blow for our offense because just how much of an impact Mitchell has brought to this team. So we're going to be relying on Jeff Wilson and Jamichael Hasty, and we also signed Brian Hill. But something that I saw today, which was really encouraging to me, was Jeff Wilson talking about the game. He said, I want to take their souls when I'm running out there. So obviously Jeff Wilson, I love him. He's a beast when he's out there. He hasn't played a whole lot, but he hasn't played the greatest either when he's out there. He's getting slowed down a little bit. But I think hopefully if he has that attitude coming tomorrow, we're in for a heck of a game from him. But we definitely need to implement them early. Next key of the game is stop Cordell Patterson. Like I said, if you stop him, you pretty much stop the Falcons offense because the only other threat they have on the offensive side of the ball is Kyle Pitts. And I think the defense, we're going to have Nick Bosa is going to have a great game again, and we're going to put a lot of pressure on Matt Ryan. I think they're going to be really discombobulated, this offense, and hopefully bring the Niners to a quick and hopefully stressful or unstressful game. The third most keys of the game is avoid turnovers on the offensive side of the ball for the Niners. Jeff Wilson, he's had a history of of fumbleitis. He fumbles a lot, so I think Hasty does too sometimes. So with those two out there, I definitely need to hold the ball, because we have to limit our mistakes, because this Falcons team, they're almost 500. They can find ways to win. And if the 49ers beat themselves up, you could see the Falcons somehow winning by a field goal, or just in a way that would just be really depressing for the Niners to lose. The fourth key to the game is going to be no picks by Jimmy. Jimmy's had a reputation of throwing the ball right to linebackers when good defenses switch up their formations to confuse quarterbacks. You've seen Jimmy many times do this. Fortunately, like last game, we got lucky. He threw the ball right to the dude and he dropped it. So we've gotten bailed out, but you can't expect to get bailed out every single time. So we have to make sure that Jimmy needs to make sure that he doesn't let that happen, and he needs to be able to pick up on that really quickly so we can limit those mistakes, because the turnovers is really what's probably going to be the biggest factor this game. And as long as Jimmy protects the ball, hopefully we can get the run game going and we'll be in good hands. So for my hard hit minute this week in the Falcons game, it's going to be all about Juwan Jennings. I think he's going to have a big touchdown catch to seal this game off, just like he had that big catch in last game. Juwan Jennings he's continued to rise, and he's taken over that wide receiver 3 spot. He's kind of taken over what Kendrick Bourne did, and hopefully he can keep improving in these weeks to come, and hopefully have a great receiver 3 for the next coming years, because he's just such a big body. He can really body up some, muscle up some defenders. I really love Juwan Jennings ever since we drafted him. I'm so happy he got his chance finally this year, and just see him improving every single year, or every single game. And he just has so much fun playing the game. I love seeing his interviews after the big game he had, after his first touchdown catch and everything. He just loves the game, and he has this opportunity to show what he can do. And I'm happy that we get to see him. So, Juwan Jennings, you're my hard hit minute of the week. And also, it's gonna be 28-23 Niners. It's going to be a close one at the end, but I think the Niners are going to make a big stop with the defense, and we'll have Jimmy and the offense out on the field, and we'll kneel it a couple times, and it'll be game over. 8-6 Niners. That's my hard hit minute for the week, baby. That's going to do it for this 49ers-Falcons pregame series. Just a quick little thing. I was really excited. I wanted to tell you guys about me going to the game. Levi Stadium right there. Just keep looking at it. It's just crazy. Never had a hotel where I could see the stadium right outside my window. Hit myself with the microphone. But if you guys see me at the game, come say hi. It's gonna be stellar seeing all the 49er fans there. First time being in that big electric environment again since the Packers game, NFC Championship. Super excited. Can't wait to see the people around me, sitting next to me in my seats. And it's just going to be a great day. And expect to see some Instagram stuff on my feed. Going to be posting all day long about my experience in the stadium. And I'll try to get a podcast also after the game. We'll see, because it's going to be a crazy day for me. So I don't know if I'll be able to get a podcast out tomorrow. Maybe Monday. We'll see. But I hope you guys had a good one. I'll see you guys Sunday, and I'll see you back there at Levi Stadium. I'll see you in the morning. Get some good rest. Go Niners, and stay faithful, baby. I'll see you guys later. Anybody going to the game, I'll try to see you there too. Have a good one, guys.
Touchdown, San Francisco!